In this video, I'll be trying to point you in the right direction on how to get Linux installed onto a system with UEFI Secure Boot. Now, we started seeing UEFI Secure Boot with Windows 8 and latterly to the end of Windows 7. So it's really a system that was manufactured between the late 2012 and, well, onwards now. So traditionally on a system, we had a BIOS. And this is what first opens up when you turn your computer on, and you used to get this awful basic DOS screen. So that's an old BIOS. This predates UEFI. And its replacement is this. So UEFI stands for Unified Extendable Firmware Interface. Now this had some quite good ideas on here. You can allow for larger hard drives to be used, and you get a nice graphical screen. So it's a lot nicer to use really than the BIOS was. However, Microsoft realised that they're losing ground to Linux and Macintosh, that they now wanted to prevent those systems from being installed, so they can try and regain some of the market share. Oh, hang on, sorry, that's not the reason, is it? No, the reason for Secure Boot is because malware was getting installed onto the boot sector and basically totally messing Windows up for people. So because that operating system is so insecure now that they're making Linux users suffer. Anyway, two Linux distributions have paid the fine to Microsoft and are allowed to be installed onto a Windows 8 Secure Boot system. And that is Fedora 18 and Ubuntu 12.10 and Ubuntu 13.04 development. So those two systems can be installed because Red Hat and Canonical have paid the fine to Microsoft. Now there's something from ASUS in the workings, but I'm not sure what they've actually come up with. There's no final announcement from them. I'm sure they will, because ASUS are partly owned by a Microsoft company, so no doubt they'll be able to boot up. It does work installing Ubuntu 12.10, as I'll show you here, and you'll see that I've got Windows 8 Secure Boot enabled, and then when I reboot, I can boot into Ubuntu 12.10. That's all fine and well if you're happy to use either Ubuntu 12.10, 13.04 or Fedora 18. But if you want to use another Linux distro, then it's going to get more awkward. You could see if there's a way of turning off the Secure Boot. On this ASUS motherboard I've got, you can see I have the setting on there. Now you can check on your own system. That's usually press the F2 key or delete as soon as you turn your system on. You can probably get into the UEFI settings from there. Some laptops can be more difficult. I've heard one that's a button on there that's technical support. So, you know, you're probably going to have to look on the manufacturer's website to find out. And you can see there if there's a setting to, well, disable Secure Boot. Nothing wrong with that. You know, it's this whole thing from Microsoft in blowing it out of proportion. I'm not convinced it's that much of a risk. So if you can disable Secure Boot that way, that's fine. Otherwise, I do believe that there are ways of getting the Linux kernel and grub bootloader linked up to a Secure Boot. I've got to admit, I'm not sure on that. I've heard of people doing it, but I suppose you've got to be really knowledgeable and dedicated into using Linux, and I'm sorry it has to be that way. But you know, the other option is that, you know, it's down to the manufacturer. They're forcing us down this route. So if you're not happy, go and return the laptop or desktop. Just return the system to the store and say it is not suitable for the purposes that you're expecting of it. You know, and I think, well, certainly in the UK, we've got a year's manufacturer's warranty on there. But I think probably within the reasoning of it being an unsuitable product, probably will last longer than a year. It's going to be one that you'll have to fight with the retailer for that. Could be an interesting thing. I'm sorry, there's no real answer for all this. It's going to vary from each system, and it's going to be something that you may have to fight for a refunds over and in order to try and get a suitable product. Anyway, I hope you might have found that useful. So thanks for watching. I'll see you later.